live, yeah.
Anna.
On which one?
On my Facebook, they're on it all.
It's worked! Yeah!
Yeah, I'm getting YouTube notifications as well.
It's working, but there's no comments. How do you get all the comments in one?
Hello everyone. Just bob down. Hello everyone. So hopefully this is working currently, and hopefully we are on Facebook, YouTube, Twitch and Periscope. So if you could just give us a yelp if you're on YouTube, Twitch and Periscope, because I know we're on Facebook because people are speaking, which is really good. But could do with everybody if you could let me know if you're on YouTube and... Oh, I can hear myself over there. Yeah, let me know if you can hear me and see me and comment to me on YouTube, Twitch and Periscope.
Pardon?
Live on YouTube, yeah.
This is good, this is good. This is basically a test run for Saturday. Oh, I can see you on Twitch but not comment. I don't know how to make comments work. Anyway, we shall see. Oh, look, somebody commented from YouTube. Hoi hoi too. Awesome. This says good. This is good. Awesome. Right, well, we're going to... Basically, the format for tonight is we're just going to play, like, three songs and then do a bit of a question and answer session, because this is just a trial run to make sure that all the 3 days' worth of trying to get cameras, audio, editing software and... multi-streaming, multi-platform streaming things works. So if everybody could just let us know that you can hear... Hey, somebody commented from Twitch. Awesome. We are doing good. Cool. Right. So yeah, we're going to play a couple of songs and then question answer. Right. This one, first one, is Anaesthetise from my second album.
Yeah.
Stop banging into that guitar, shall I?
Depravity.
the shade behind the eyes. And as the fool could prophesy, positive comments. Thank you so much. Everybody's saying the sound's really good and the camera's really good, which took me like 3 days to sort out. 3 days of pulling my hair out and just flapping, basically. 3 days of utter flappage this was. Yeah. How flappy was this? This was quite flappy, wasn't it, Jamie? Let them know how flappy I was.
There was a lot of flappage, but now there's a lot of clappage. Sorry, that was terrible.
And a lot of smileage. because, yeah, today's been the most weird day ever, hasn't it? Like, I got up and went, God, my roots look awful. I'm going to Boots to buy some hair dye. Oh, I was looking at that because there's a delay. So I was looking at that going, you're about to speak because you've just picked the microphone up and then realised actually in real life there's like a 30-second delay. Anyway, blonde moment. Literally, which I can now say because I did my own roots. So anyway, yes. So literally I was like, I got this like hair colour on and then I left it on for like a lot longer than you should, thinking, oh my goodness me, my hair's going to fall out. And then I got a voiceover order that I was like, oh, I've got to do it now, I've got to do it now. And eventually took my hair dye off and had ginger roots, which was fabulous. And then it doesn't look that bad though, it's all right.
So, someone says I'm on the cola light. I feel like I need to kind of say I'm not.
Jamie on the cola light? No, we've got we've actually got some Tom Coco from Brew York going on at the moment, which was. After 3 days of flappage, it was like, I need a tongue. Anyway, so we are now going to play the next song. This one is Foolish Games.
You're
Sorry, this is the expression of thank goodness it still works. Literally, flappage after 3 days. And there's still people watching, which is fabulous. So we're going to... I've got my slippers on, so I can't touch my pedals. Have a quick slurp of Diet Cola. So we're going to do this last one, and then we're going to do a bit of a question and answer session. I nearly just said a question and answer session.
Very RP. Very RP there.
I did this voiceover thing today, or an NHS one, and it was like, I sent it to my dad, and he's like, goodness me, Chantel, you sound very posh on this. Because all my T's and S's are pronounced really, like, properly. Instead of, like, commonly.
You'll be treading the boards next. You become a right thespian.
A thespian? Nah, I don't think so. Although, I don't know. Anyway, so, yeah, a lot of people have said, the camera's really good, and the sound's really good. And, yeah, so the camera thing, it ended up after all these weeks of the phone not working and then being on the tablet and then the GoPro not working and everything just being wrong. I ended up downloading this like program to do it from my phone and use that as a webcam and get that into the computer and then downloading more programs to process that and then subscribing to this thing to multi-stream it to everything. So it's been, yeah. Anyway, so we're going to do this one and then we're going to have a little chit-chat about stuff and send you little, don't send them in yet because I can't read while I'm playing because that means multitasking. So if you wait a couple of minutes till I've finished April and then send your questions on the chat and then, yeah, we'll do a little bit of a question and answer. Yeah.
Thank you.
love it. Kevin Duff just put, nice touch of jazz there. Is that the wrong note? It's like, is that the bit where I went wrong? Anyway, so if you would like to send your comments, as in like questions, question answer, question, we will do our best to answer them. So I think we're about 30 seconds behind you. So if you want to send your questions and we'll answer them in 30 seconds. Can you run through your rig and pedals that you are using, Chantel? You don't want to know about the live streaming rig, because to be honest, I don't actually know. Rig, I am basically using my guitar into a Tech 20. I don't know why I've still got these things in my ears, because I don't need them. A Tech 21 Richie Kotzen pedal. And that's it, and it's going straight into the interface, which is a Rubik's 4-4, into the computer, as it is now. Was into a phone, now it's not. That's that. Was keen to ask the we are looking forward to watching you play, but are there any gigs you are looking forward to going to watch? I would love to go see Stephen Wilson, hopefully this next year, but who knows? It'd be nice to go, but I don't know, I need to buy a ticket. what do you enjoy most about being a musician? Songwriting, recording in the studio, being on stage and playing to a live audience? I don't know, all of it. They're all fun. Oh, that was from Paul. Hi, Paul. They're all fun. They're all different. Stephen Wilson's new album, what do you think, from Ian Faultless? it's different and it takes a lot of listens, but I like it.
I think it sounds very kind of early 80s Gary Newman. Sounds a bit kind
I really like it.
Yeah, what's that album? I Assassin, the 1982 Gary Newman album.
Which I like it. It's good. I feel weird because I'm like looking back at you. It's like, I wish. I don't know if there's a way of moving this so that I can actually look at you rather. I don't want to give myself
Why
a
Why would
bad
you
want to
do that?
Oh, Jamie, don't put yourself down. right, yeah, I can kind of see you a bit more now, so I look like I'm talking to you rather than not. Right. Yeah, I'm still in the camera view. Right, so what do I think of it? I like it. I do like it. It reminds me quite of a lot of the last album. There's quite a bit of To the Bone on there with like Song of Iron, stuff like that. Sounds quite similar to the new stuff.
Right, I've got to scroll up to the top. Come back.
Oh, I can do it on my leg. That's good. Right. I've done that one.
Yeah,
next time you,
I think the top of my head is slightly cut off, so it's.
Sorry, do you want me to move it so you can see your head?
Certainly, someone just mentioned it. Yeah, it's not about me; it's about you. I'm just in the background. You know. Yeah.
Is that there? Oh, you can't see because it's 30 seconds.
Yeah.
And this isn't on anymore. Oh my goodness.
There we go. Yeah.
Is that
Hopefully that's a bit better. Right, next time you do a brew, if it's a dark ale or a stout, add a tin of cherries to it. I think you will like the results. We're actually brewing at the moment a Belgian strawberry dark beer, which will be interesting. do you prefer to play acoustic or electric from David Southwood? I don't know, I like both. They're both different. Will there be a new album on the horizon yet? I'm 4 songs left to do in the shed session. Literally, they're recorded, they just need mixing. And then mastering, pressing up, and then that's it. What songs, when they're on the radio or TV, do you want to make the sound up? True Blood soundtrack with Jace Everett's Bad Things, because it's great. Who are your major influences? From Simon Campagnoli. I've probably said that wrong. I don't know, I listen to a lot of country music at the moment. I drive you up the wall, don't I? Country, it's radio on permanent. Jamie loves it. John Atkinson, is Jamie going to feature at any of your gigs?
Who knows?
You might come along and drink some beer.
Might come along and be a spectator, yeah.
Come and heckle me.
Yeah.
what did you have for dinner? We've not eaten it yet. All I've had to eat today is a cereal bar from Lidl. I didn't have breakfast because I went to Boots to get my hair colour. Then at lunchtime, I forgot because I were too busy flapping about my hair being ginger and doing this voiceover thing. And then I were going to have some super noodles, but I forgot, and I've not had oat yet. So nothing, literally nothing yet. But it is going to be spicy pork and rice from the Hairy Dieter's book. Who would you say your biggest... Oh, I've done that one. We can't see Jamie's face. Is it possible to make him smaller or...
That was from.
Were it from like Father Ted or something? Small but far away. Right. What are the tracks on the new Shed Sessions 2 CD? I don't know, because I want to do a north. Well, I've done the northern one. That just needs finishing. And then I want to do a southern one with you. I'm doing piano-y stuff and electric stuff. That'll be fun. Reschedule. What, you were meant to be playing your rescheduled Clooney gig on Friday. Is there a new date for it? Yes, there is, but I can't remember what it is. I think it's on my website. Where can I buy a shirt that Jeremy has on?
I got it. I got it.
I thought I read these
4 years ago. 4 years ago? No, 3 years ago from TK Maxx. I was actually too fat to wear it, but I've actually managed to kind of since the pandemic, I've managed to kind of lose a little bit.
Most people have drunk loads of beer and eaten loads of food, but you've lost weight.
Well, a little bit, but it means I can fit into the banana shirt now. So TK Maxx. It was a few years ago, so I think it was about $29.99. Actually, no, I remember I bought a. Was it? No, I bought it and it was too small for me, but I loved it so much I just waited until.
I've done so many things that I've done that so many times. I bought a nice apricot dress just before pandemic, and I was like, "It's a size 6, but I like it anyway." And it's in the sale, and it was like half price. I'm gonna fit into it one day, and it's still hung on my mum's wardrobe because I'm never gonna fit into a size 6 realistically. Okie doke. Who is your favourite guitarist and singer? Ooh, I really like Brad Paisley. I know it's country, but I think his guitar playing is fantastic. And I like his songs because they're good. What music have you listened to lately? Country, Stephen Wilson, that's pretty much it. Can you play slide guitar? No, I'm rubbish at it. I'm absolutely terrible at it. Does the new technology mean you'll be streaming live to YouTube as well as Facebook in the future? I don't have Facebook, so I will be waiting for the uploads on YouTube. Yes, it does. So every Saturday now at 5 p.m. UK time, we'll be streaming to Facebook, Twitch. I keep wanting to call it Twitcher. Is that like what birdwatching is? Twitchers. Facebook, Twitch, Periscope, and YouTube. It will be on all of them. And if they add any more channels, it'll be on them as well. There's loads of like places in Asia that there's channels for it on and stuff, but I don't have a clue what they are, and I can't sign up to a website because I can't read like Chinese. What other electric guitars do you have, or is the Ernie Ball covering all what you need? I use the Ernie Ball. When I'm in the studio, I tend to use the Ernie Ball or my Strat, which is a Strat Plus Deluxe, but Dad made it into a Frankenstein thing and put some Seymour Duncan stacked humbuckers on it, which is nice. Kevin Swan, I've suggested a tip jar during COVID for the 19, not for the 19, COVID for the
19.
Many earn favour as a way to support. For the cost of a pint, we get 60-minute gig. Yes. I wasn't going to mention this, but since somebody's brought it up, it's just easier, isn't it? So I know the whole thing I said at the start of the thing, at the start of streaming, I was like, I'm not going to charge because I'm not, and I'm still not going to charge. I am going to put a little PayPal link, not tonight, when we do his full proper sessions, which I've stressed, also flapped my face off about for last week. But it's because it's now costing me basically to stream because I've had to buy the camera thing and also buy the monthly subscription to Restream. Because it's free if you don't want to stream to your Facebook page, which is annoying because that's the place that I really want to stream to. So I've got to do a monthly subscription to Restream basically. So it's now costing me. So I am going to pop a thing, but I don't expect anybody to put out in it. If you want to chuck a quid in, awesome. If you don't, just watch it and enjoy it and share it with your friends, and that's fine by me. Just enjoy it anyway. I'm not bothered. I'm not doing it tonight, obviously, because this is just like us being us and having a pint with friends, basically. I think this is in it.
Absolutely.
This is what it's like in the living room. We just sit, have a pint and chat to people and it's lovely. Right. What is your favourite song to cover? Ooh, I really like that Jewel song, actually, Foolish Games, because I get to kind of be a bit more thoughtful with my voice. Which I don't get to do really with the band because I'm always just like.
Do you think about the meaning of the lyrics and you use like acting through song to tell a story?
Oh yes, Jamie. Oh yes. That were about good enough to be on like Corrie, wasn't it? That. what studio do you use? I use one in London. I work with Livy Brown, who, I don't know where he is now, he might be back in Godalming, I'm not sure. Favourite country act, past or present? All of them. probably Brad Paisley at the moment, because I'm just obsessing on him. I realise with the expenses, permits and now COVID that it will be tough to tour in the States. Is there anyone or band that you would open for on the tour that you won't outshine? I won't outshine anyone. I'd love to tour like in the States. I'd really love to tour in the States, but I think it'd be nice to even think about touring in Europe at the moment. I can't see that happening either. There's about as much chance as going to Lapland, I think. Is that an actual place? It is a place, isn't it? Yeah. Seeing Santa in Lapland, then. Yeah, I don't know. It would be lovely to go to America. Actually, there's probably more chance of going to America than Europe now. The visas are probably cheaper. can we pre-order the Shed Sessions CD? Not quite yet. When I've finished it and ordered it, then I'll be doing a pre-order thing. Because I'm a bit weird like that, and I like it to be definitely being pressed so that I can say I will be receiving it on this date or thereabouts and you should be getting it by this date, rather than just kind of going, well, it'll come sometime in 6 months and who knows when. I'd rather it be set in stone that it is coming, it is being manufactured, and then, you know, before I take any money. Would it be possible to do Daydream in the Shed session? Charlie Churchill, I did it last week. Oh no, you didn't miss it. You've watched every one of them, in fact. We did it last week in the Shed session. I'll do it next on Saturday as well in the Shed session. Remind me and I'll do it. What is Stevie's favourite song? That's Katie Neat, our lovely friend Katie. Stevie's favourite song is probably When We're Quiet.
I think something by the Hamsters, don't you think?
Very nice.
Did you ever see that?
I never saw the Hamsters, but a lot of our friends and fans and stuff liked the Hamsters. But I never
they used
got
to be
see
quite
them.
Big, hmm? Yeah, back yeah. in the day.
I reckon he'd like Cats in the Cradle and the Silver Spoon.
I don't know what that is. Oh. Is that a nursery rhyme, was it?
No, it was by the... what's that band called? It's the band that Curly Carl likes, The Stranglers.
Oh, is it? Oh, I like The Stranglers, but I haven't heard that one. But,
yeah. You probably have. It's like their most famous song. Never mind.
That one.
Oh, that was... Okay, that one. No, not that one. How about switching off the reverb while talking? I don't know how to do it. Hang on. I don't know if I've done it or not. Might have done it. Has it gone off? Has it? Yeah. It's a good job because I didn't have a clue what I were doing with that then. Would you consider doing something with Joanne Shaw Taylor? Yeah, she's awesome. She's really cool and she's a really nice person too. Edward Milano asked if there would be a live album, which I actually released one last year. Was it last year? What year is it? 21 now?
Yeah.
No, that came out in 19, I think, didn't it? Yeah.
I don't know.
It's on my website if you want to have a look at it anyway. What was the first song that you mastered when you first were starting? I remember it's either... what was that song? I remember when I was about 7, my guitar teacher made me learn Brown Eyed Girl from Notation. And it was awful. It was just like, bloop, 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 bloop. And it drove everybody insane, and I hated it, and I still can't listen to that song, so probably that one.
And then I can't stand that, because actually it reminds me of weddings. It's playing weddings and drunk people singing along with it. It's yeah.
It sounds like that anyway. Yeah. It's awful. Yeah. What is it you're all drinking? I couldn't understand your accent. Most people can't.
Tonkoku.
From Brew York. It's a brewery in York, funnily enough. And it's a coconut... Is it a stout or a porter?
I think it's a stout.
I think it's a stout, isn't it? It's a coconut vanilla-y type stout. It's delicious. Jamie, your mum's put that she bought your shirt.
No, that was the one with the lemons on. I bought this one I got bought the one with lemons on, which is I have one for the said sessions.
I'm glad you called it that, not something else.
Yeah. I have worn it for that. So that was the lemons.
Mm. What was it like to work on the album in November 2020, the Dr. John album, Gumbo Blues? It was good, actually. It was all done remotely. So basically, they sent over the track. Cleopatra Records in America sent over the track. I went in my little home studio thing and recorded my guitar parts. I actually did a vocal part first time around. And then I sent them it and they put it into the track and it all worked out really nicely. Do you like Brothers Osborne? I think they're brilliant. I think Brothers Osborne are really cool as well. I've been playing a few tracks of theirs on my Hard Rock Hell radio show on a Monday morning at 10 a.m. I had to get that in.
I got a bit confused. I got a bit excited about that question because I thought it was, do you like the Brothers Johnson? I was like, I love the Brothers Johnson.
Who are they?
It's just like, get the funk out of my face. Get the funk out of my face. It's like kind of like funk
that was
70s band.
That was Funk, by the way. Yeah. F-U-N-K.
Yes, yeah. Yeah,
just to clarify.
Yeah, they're really good. Yeah, 70s.
Never heard of them. Mm. I prefer Brothers Osborne, their country. Yeah. Could you just say one word in French? Merci.
I thought you were going to say something else beginning with M then in French.
Why, what else? Don't tell me. Don't tell me. Tell me later, Jane.
Naughty word.
I'm trying to read these all seem really jumbled up, but they're not. Nick Garner put, I hope you're safe and well and that your dad is misbehaving as ever. Of course. I would expect no less from him. Are you worried about being able to tour in Europe? Yes. I think we're probably a little bit screwed. That's the nicest way of putting it. I mean, it wasn't particularly viable before touring in Europe. It was always a bit of a, you know, you kind of paying to do it because it, you know, it was lovely to go and everything. And we love playing Europe and we love being there and meeting different people. But it was always costly to do it. And now I think now there's going to be visas and carnets and stuff like that. It's just going to be unviable completely to do it. But we shall see if they change anything or, you know, get a lottery win or might win on Sky Lotto. Mm. I might start playing bingo, Jamie. Mm. Sky Bingo. Actually, I did win. I went on Sky Bingo because you got a free bingo game on it. And I won £6 odd, didn't I? First time I did it, it was great. That's what they do, though. They hook you in. Are you in touch with Tom and Colin? Yes, I am. I speak to him quite well. I WhatsApp him quite a bit. Basically, to just say to him, hi, pups. So this gig's now been cancelled and moved to blah, blah, blah. And that's about it. That's pretty much it. But I think they're doing okay. Yeah, I think they're all right. What grade level is Jamie? Like 7 squillion?
102? No. I did a grade 8 in, I think, 2001. But it's kind of like saying, what did you get for your music GCSE? It's that kind of...
I didn't do music GCSE. Yeah.
Nor did I.
I did my grade 8.
I did A level, but I didn't do GCSE.
I didn't do A level. They didn't run it at my school. I did GCSE.
Oh, I didn't do it at school either. I did it afterwards when I realised I got into music a bit late. But
I wanted to do it at GCSE, but they wouldn't run it because there were only 3 people wanted to do it at school. So the music teacher kindly said she'd teach it in the lunchtime, but then she sadly passed away, so didn't get GCSE. They didn't run music A level anyway, so I did my normal A levels and then went to Leeds College of Music and did a BTEC in popular music and then did my degree and then ran away from education because it's really stressful. I finished my degree, just to clarify. I didn't run away that quick. People are still talking about Cats in the Cradle. Oh, that's because I'm 6 minutes behind.
Yeah.
That's why. How did the Hard Rock Hell radio presenting happen? That happened basically at the start of, it was the end of May Bank Holiday weekend, and they got in touch and said, do you fancy doing a one-off show on a Monday night at 9 o'clock? And I was like, yeah, that'd be good fun. I've never done a radio show before. I've done lots of interviews, but I've never had a show. So I thought, yes, I would love to do that. So I did it, 2-hour show, and they were like, we really like you. Do you want to do every week for 2 hours on a Monday morning? And I was like, yeah, that'd be lovely. So I did it, and I'm still doing it, and it's great fun. And sometimes I do the breakfast show as well, which I think is this Friday. What date is it today? 10th, yeah. Yeah, on Friday I'm doing the breakfast show at 8 o'clock till 10 o'clock as well. So, lovely. Sorry, I'm just looking through all the comments and scrolling through, and I can't read and talk at the same time. David Southwood put, I seem to have missed the Shed Sessions CD. Is it still available? It's not out yet. You can't have missed it that much. It's not out yet. John Atkinson's had our Tom Coco Milk Stout. Not ours, but he's had a different one. Katie Neat put, if you could create a supergroup, which musicians, past and present, would you recruit? I would put... Do I have to be in it? Or can I can I just pick some musicians I like and listen to them? I'd put Guthrie Govan on guitar. I'll just watch. Singers. I don't really listen to many singers. Probably I'd just like have Stephen Wilson's band. That I'd do. Like when he had like Craig in it and Guthrie. And then I'll just sit and watch. I'll just go to a Stephen Wilson gig. That'll do. Blah, 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 blah. Did you play with Chris Ainley or just kick him off stage? Chris Ainley, bless him, now lives in Australia, but he used to jam with me when other bass players wouldn't get up and play with me at jam sessions when I was 12 to 16. Because I was a little girl. He was the one with his bright green bass who used to get on stage. Where are you going? Are you going for a wee? Sorry. He used to get on stage with me, and he was the one that would get up there and play Natalie Imbruglia songs with me and stuff like that. And he was lovely, and he still is lovely, and he's in Australia. With a name like McGregor, do you have Scottish roots? Yes. My great granddad was from Glasgow, I think. -7 in England apparently tonight. Looks cold. How much are you missing standing or moving about when you play? Not really. I don't get footache anymore quite as much. Especially now I've stopped wearing Skechers and started wearing Docs. I was having a really bad problem with my foot and I don't know what's up with it. But anyway. Is Jamie grade 8? Yeah, he's beyond grade. I think he's got a master's. Jamie, have you got a master's? Yeah, he has. Would you like to get into acting? Yeah, I think it'd be good fun. One of my best friends has asked me if I want to do a show reel with her, some acting stuff, which could be really good fun. I think I'd enjoy it. Did you enjoy collaborating, playing? No, hang on, I'm reading this all wrong. Did you enjoy playing on the Three Colours Dark track with John and Rachel and any other collaborations coming soon? I loved it. It was really good fun. They sent me the track through, and then, like with the Dr. John thing, I played the guitar part in the studio at home and sent them the bits that I'd done, and they really liked it, and it went on the album, and that was lovely, and it was lovely to work with them. If you could perform with anyone dead or alive, who would it be? Probably Jeff Buckley, because he's lovely. What song or artist first got you into country? Probably just listening to Country It's Radio, which came about because me and Dad had gone out up to Elvington. There's an airfield up there that does track days. So we sometimes go up there. Well, we don't anymore, obviously, but we used to go up there and watch track days with fast cars. Anyway, we'd gone out in Mitzi, and we were sat next to this car next to us that had like this really banging country on. And I've never said the word banging in my life. Why did I just say that? Like some rocking country. And I was like, this is amazing. Listen to that music. It's fabulous. And then I heard like the tag bit, which is like, you're listening to Country It's Radio. And I was like, oh my God, there's a radio station. So I did the DAB thing, found it. And then that was it. That was about 2 years ago. And I've been constantly had it on permanently ever since, much to everybody's annoyance. But I like it. I always have to wait for Chantel to post the Hard Rock Hell shows onto her website. Yeah, I know, I'm a bit lax with it. I need to do. Have you heard of Chris Stapleton? Yes, he's wonderful. His voice is incredible. Did you wash your hands, Jamie?
No, riddled with COVID, so...
spreading yes, it. Yes. He always washes his hands and puts the toilet seat down.
Yeah, I kind of always have, I think, yeah.
Very gentlemanly.
Yeah, I don't know. The toilets just don't look... Well, the thing is, actually, with a soft-closed toilet seat, you know, there's no excuse, really. You just have to literally just give it a...
You go...
Give it a flick.
And it does it.
And it just goes down.
It's good. Are you going to make another music video one day? Yeah. Like... Do you mean like a me and Jamie homemade one, or do you mean like a proper one? Not that yours are proper.
No, I think it means a proper one, like a you know, there's
like
a,
there's take the power.
There's a story and there's a
the posh ones.
Yeah.
Not that yours are posh. Yeah. Yours have got a story. It's the evolution of the fridge. Yeah, we will. I will. We will. We both will. There's no more comments coming. Like they're stuck. Has everybody gone?
No, I think that, no, it's just you've caught up.
Oh my goodness, that never happens. So if everybody could think of some more comments, else we'll have to go and watch Silent Witness, and we're a bit sick of it because we've binge watched it for 2 weeks. Anyone? Any more comments? Are they actually coming in, or is it just?
Yeah, they are. Yeah,
they're
you've just caught up. Yeah, you've caught up.
I'm just going to check it on my other. How do I do it?
Yeah, they're coming through.
Oh, look, Jane and Pete are watching. Hi, Jane and Pete. What is your dream guitar? Dream guitar is probably my Petrucci. I love it. It's great. Any more telltales in the offing? Thanks, Paul. No, I don't have time at the moment. I would love to do... Actually, I did say the other week when we were walking back from the shops, it would be really fun to do a podcast of us two just talking rubbish for 15 minutes. Don't know. Might do something like that. I know I can't keep up again. So I would love to do it, especially since I'm still paying the subscription on the podcasting thing that's £7 a month or whatever it is. But, you know, time permitting, yeah. If not a singer, what would you be? An actress, I reckon, at the moment. I think it'd be. I think I'd quite like being an actress.
That or a pathologist, was it?
Or a forensic pathologist, yeah.
Socco.
No, I wouldn't want to be one of them, because then you've got to actually deal with them. I want to be like, what's her face? What's she called in program?
Sam Ryan.
No, not Sam Ryan. She's too grumpy. The other one. The perky one.
Nikki
Alexander. Yeah. Yeah, I'd be like Nikki Alexander. Can I ask Ali Venable to invite you on her chat show on a Sunday night? Yeah, that'd be good fun. I would love to. Jane Carver, what's wrong with Silent Witness? It's great. Favourite Porcupine Tree album? Probably Deadwing. Yeah, probably Deadwing. Will you play... Perhaps you will... Oh, play again. do you like playing festivals? I love playing festivals. They're probably my favouritest thing because they're great. Dawson's making watch Dawson's Creek. To be fair, I have still been watching Dawson's Creek. When Jamie has a bath or a shower, I watch Dawson's Creek and I love it. Favourite curry restaurant? Well, being from Bradford, at the moment it would be the Karachi on Neil Street, which used to be next to the mortuary, which isn't a mortuary anymore. But we did get one the other night and it was kind of a bit underwhelming, wasn't it?
It was all right, yeah.
It was
back
average.
To back to Chinese, I think.
It was expensive and it was average and it didn't have much chicken in it and it wasn't a Bradford curry. And that's the problem, is wherever I go and get a curry, I'm like, it's not a Bradford curry.
But you can at least, you know, get alcohol.
What, here?
Yeah.
You can't go to a pub. Mm? What do you mean?
Yeah, but the one you like, you can't get alcohol, so it's like...
Yeah, well, that's fine. Yeah. That's all right.
You
I don't
can't
mind.
You can't have a curry without a pint.
Yeah,
can't
you
a curry
can.
And a mango lassi.
Yeah, you can.
No.
No, because
no, you've got to have a pint with a curry, I think.
No, you have your pints first, right? You go to Fighting Cock, yeah. Have a load of beer, and yeah. Then go to the Karachi.
Okay.
Yeah. That's the idea with it. And then you don't eat all of it because you're too full because you've had pints.
Yes.
That's the idea. And then you take it home because you've got some for breakfast. Right. Have you watched The Fall? Gritty Did we watch The Fall?
Yeah. How could you not?
Is that the Benedict Girl?
Yeah, it was that
is
one.
Is that
yeah.
That one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
With Gillian Anderson.
With Scully. Yeah, we really enjoyed The Fall. Yeah. That was really good. I think we watched that in like one night. I tell you what we did watch last week. Oh my goodness me. We watched It's a Sin and it is absolutely amazing. I almost want to watch it again because it was so... heartbreaking. And
I was just waiting for the Pet Shop Boys song, which I love.
It was
it's a sin,
near the
and
end.
It was in there.
It was in there when he did the jukebox in the pub. I don't know. I can't hear you. I've not got the things in. Oh, watch It's a Sin. It is amazing. It's so good. Where have I got? When will you be making another documentary like with you did with your dad and the beer making? Oh, we could do a little like, this is how you make beer. Although it's not that interesting because we're only
when
doing.
When we do the all grain, maybe it's more of a.
When we can afford a pot.
Yeah.
That wasn't a pot to in. Yeah. By the way, that was. Because we're saving up for a boiler, is what we're doing, with an electric element, because you've got an electric cooker hob thing. And I don't think it'd work right quite as well doing the boil on there. So we're saving up for one of them. So one day when we get onto all grain brewing, we should do a video. What's the best you hope for this year? pubs to open, I think, at this rate. No, I don't think that was a bit shallow, Chantel. I don't know, just for everybody to be happy, healthy.
World
get
peace.
Get to end of it.
World peace.
You make me sound like Miss Congeniality.
I remember I saw that at the cinema.
It's a good film. We should watch it again. just that everybody's happy and healthy and gets to end of year probably would be a nice start. Some gigs would be nice. Lush to reopen so that I can go buy some bath bombs. When are the Shed Tessions t-shirts coming? When the CD's done? It'll be both of them. Flapjacks or brownies? Flapjack.
Definitely flapjacks.
Flapjacks. I went through a phase of baking them, didn't I? Flapjacks for a bit, and then never did them again. Any chance you can timestamp the track list in the description on YouTube? I don't have a clue how to do that. It's lucky it's getting on YouTube at the moment. I don't know how to do that.
You will be able to do that. I don't know if you can do that. You might have to do that post.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
You might have to teach me how to do that because I don't know what I'm doing with that. Would you rather be attacked by a single giant duck or 100 tiny bears?
1,000.
1,000 tiny bears. I would rather be attacked by 1,000 tiny bears because I think they'd be really cute. And it's kind of not attacked if they're tiny because they're just so cute and squishy. And I just want to cuddle them.
Don't forget though, with a duck, when you think about a bear and what a duck can do, a duck.
Duck's
pet. You might get attacked by it, but you might not.
No, a duck's
not
pet.
Damage, whereas actually 1,000 tiny bears can.
Hey, think of Asbo Swan or whatever it was called. What were it called? Asbo Swan. Do you remember? Swazbo. Asbo. Asbo Swan.
No, I don't know. Don't know what you're talking about.
There was a thing ages ago about this. Or maybe it was a goose. No, it was a swan. There was like this really aggressive swan. That was attacking people.
I thought you were talking about a film, some kind of film. Like
no,
what
was
that?
No,
Asbo Swan.
Swan.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, see? Birds can be, you know. Favourite venue to play? Probably Bury St Edmunds at the Apex. I love that place. Curry, would you consider to play our open theatre here in Scarborough? I would love to, that would be lovely. When was the last time you were really drunk? I've not been drunk for ages. I don't really get. No. I don't. No, I don't. I don't like the hangover, so I just have a couple and that's it. The thing is, I don't need booze to fall over. I fall over anyway, so. It's just, I don't dare risk it anymore. They sometimes do curries at work. Once mango lassi. Why are we still on mango lassis when we're 3 minutes later?
It's because we probably
is
mentioned
the
curry. I think you answered the curry. Yeah, it's all the. It's all
oh,
the
there's
delay,
a big delay. Oh my goodness! There was an International Pancake Day race in Kansas. I didn't know about that. I'd love to go to a Pancake Day race. What is the white Petrucci in? Why is the white Petrucci the live guitar over the green one? I don't know. I don't know, really. Just because that's the one that I brought down here and the other one is up north. I guess. I don't know. hope to see you in Glasgow or Edinburgh. Me too. Henderson's or Leon Perrins? Probably Leon Perrins. Well, actually, no, it's not. It's whatever the brand is that's Lidl's own brand. Because that's what we've got. Because it was cheaper. Well, Nobody's putting out L's now.
You catch up and then there's like a...
Then it's like a big stop.
A flurry of...
Everyone's stopped. There's a McFlurry. Where's there a McFlurry? Oh, McFlurry. You can't beat a good McFlurry, actually. Not as good as the ice cream shop in Tong near Leeds, but, you know.
Don't be that bothered about McFlurries, really.
Really? Yeah. Oh, Jamie, you've not had a Smarties one, clearly. Jane put, these questions are just like our random conversations in the pub. Miss you. We miss you too. Well, you've never met Jane, but miss you too, Jane. I know, literally, it's like being our random conversations in the pub.
Well, you actually make a little bar, put a little bar here.
Well, I did say that a couple of weeks ago about the other room.
Are we just going to have a live session of basically just chat where we just have
where
a drink?
We just sit and have a beer with everybody, probably. Yeah, the other week we were on, because we've turned the little, well, it was your office, wasn't it?
Well, office as in, just a
computer room. Small, it's like a second bedroom thing, innit? And it was your kind of office thing, and well, now it's a brew room. And I said, what we could do is build a bar by the window in the corner and turn it into a little pub, which I think would be still a really good idea, but we'll see. Maybe not.
Wasn't there was that place in Wyke? There's that thing you saw where they built like an amazing pub.
Yeah.
Because I sometimes find some of these pub sheds are a bit, a bit naff. But this one was just actually...
It's lovely.
Yeah. It was like an actual
pub. It's really nice. It looks really, really lovely. It's kind of all oldie-worldy and wooden, and it looks lovely. It's the sort of pub that I'd like to go to. Maybe we should just rip out everything in that room and turn it into like an oldie-worldy pub.
Yeah, yeah.
That'd be quite funky. Jamie, what's your favourite band?
It's a toss-up between... it's a tricky one. I have to think a lot about this. S Club 7, and what's that band who did We're Going... Venger Boys. S Club 7 or Venger Boys, I think those, both seminal bands, and both... I couldn't decide between them, to be honest, but, I think they'd be one of my favourite.
In real life, though... Answer it sensibly.
In real life,
probably yes, I'd say.
No, I don't.
You listen to a lot of yes.
I think actually my favorite. I don't really have a favorite band, but I think the band I do really like, especially when it comes to kind of a proggy stuff, is Frost, which features your friend Craig.
Yes.
Frost. Who I've seen a couple of times. They're my kind of favorite.
And you've got a Frost hoodie and a Frost T-shirt.
Yeah. So they're my favorite. Although I don't really have a favorite band, but they're the one who kind of. Yeah, if I was going to say favourite band. I mean, there's too many to choose from, really.
Mm.
But
Do you ever fancy playing Swindon again? Yeah, I'd love to play Swindon. Or Bristol. Both of them places were good. If Jamie ever comes to the Diamond, will you come with him and put on a show?
I used to love gigging at the Diamond, actually. It used to be basically because we used to be able to stay over. And, you'd do the gig and then you have a few drinks and then you'd stay over and then pack up the gear in the morning.
Mm.
But,
well,
actually, that was the last time I was there was in August when we did when like an outdoor festival, yeah. Mm.
What is our favourite soup? We've been making soup, right? I bought this soup maker about 3 years ago when I went through this phase, probably on Slimming World or something, going, I'm going to make soup and I'm going to get thin, which probably never happened. And it was like a really swish soup maker and I kind of poisoned myself with with salt. Basically, I were... such a weird story. So on a Wednesday, I used to work being a barmaid in this little micro pub. And just because it was good fun, I enjoyed it. It was good. It was nice to do something different for a few hours on a Wednesday afternoon and night. And you meet new people and stuff. And it was lovely. Anyway, I decided to make mushroom soup before I went to work this particular day. And made my mushroom soup, put my kilo of mushrooms in it and a couple of litres of water and put the stock cube in that it said to put in and it didn't taste of anything, so I carried on putting stock cubes in. 14 stock cubes later it finally tasted of something, so I gave mum some and she left it because she didn't like it, and I ate it all because I was like, I've made this, I'm going to eat it. So I did, and then I went off to the pub to do my shift, and about an hour into it I was like, I feel very strange, and nearly passed out. And then started throwing up and had the runs as well. It was just like, there's something wrong. Anyway, I got salt poisoning. So I stopped making soup, and the soup maker went in the garage for a bit. Anyway, when I was coming down here, I sort of said, right, I'll bring the soup maker with me, because basically mum and dad wanted shut of it out at garage. So I brought it down, and we've made lots of soup because it's cheap to make.
Great.
So we've been buying cheap veg from like supermarket when it's on offer. Whatever basically is on offer at supermarket, veg.
It's nice, because back in lockdown one, when I was living on like, you know, absolute bread and water, it'd be like I'd get the cheapest, most horrible soup, like 31p.
I like them 31p cream of chicken.
They are
little
kind
soups.
Of quite, yeah, but I was literally living on those. But then now it's like, it's great because it's like now there's it's
fresh homemade fresh soup. Vegetable soup. Yeah. But we've kind of not got a recipe because it's just kind of whatever's on offer and cheap at like Lidl or Aldi. So we just literally, I mean, lately it's been potatoes. So like literally I put like 2 potatoes in it, about 3 onions, maybe a couple of carrots if we've got them. That's it for veg, I think. Then some salt and pepper, 2 stock cubes, a litre of water.
Rock and roll.
Some chilli powder.
Rock and roll.
Some mixed herbs, and that's it. And I've not poisoned us yet, which is really good. We've not been food poisoned for a bit. That's really good. Right, I've lost all my comments talking about soup.
Yeah.
But I do like Heinz cream of chicken and mushroom as well. Where haven't you played that you would love to gig at? Glastonbury. Because it just looks really nice and it looks really hippy dippy and they've got loads of like lovely things.
I think you'd enjoy it actually.
I'd like to go, but I don't want to pay to go. That's the
only thing. Yeah.
I'm tight in Yorkshire and I don't want to pay to get in there. It's too expensive. Who's the most famous person you've been to a party with? No.
Whose party you've been to?
Whose party I've been to? I played at Elkie Brooks's. I was the band at Elkie Brooks's doctor's leaving do, and Elkie came. Funnily enough, she rung me about 2 hours ago, and I came in and went, "Jamie, Elkie's ringing me." So she was there. That was lovely. It wasn't her party, but she was there, and she's so lovely. And I went to Aziz Ibrahim's party. He was in the Stone Roses. No, he wasn't. He was Ian Brown's guitarist from the Stone Roses. And
he played with Simply Red as well.
He did play with Simply. He also played with Stephen Wilson on one album as well.
And he played on the 1996 Asia album Arena as
well.
There you
go. Anyway, I went to his, I think it was his 50th or something in Manchester. And stood there all night and was like, yeah, this is really cool. And Ian Brown were there for a bit. And then my dad's like, you do realise who you stood next to, don't you? And I'm like, no. And like Paul Weller was stood next to me all night and I never noticed. Standard Chantel manoeuvre. Where have I got to? Yes, thank you, Katie. Stephen Margach, I think I've said that right. This one is a Q&A session, so we will be playing music on Saturday at 5 p.m. UK time. That's when we're doing this is kind of like we did some music and then we're doing a bit of a chat because it's just a test to make sure everything works on every channel before we do the proper full music one on Saturday. What is your electric plane through? I did that one earlier, but it's literally just a keep looking. Tech 21 Richie Kotzen pedal. Oh yeah, Peter Griffiths, those GI bread rolls in Lidl. Oh.
29p.
Oh, do you remember when we were getting the GI loaves? Mm. Oh, they were so good. We've started now because I don't leave the house basically ever. Because like where do you go when you can't go anywhere? So Jamie started sort of like saying we must get out of the house, and we've been walking up for bread, haven't we? Mm. On a Friday we walk up to the road to the bakery.
I'm not gonna do the accent, but we lick the road clean with our tongues.
It were harder in my day.
I'm not going to even attempt to do the accent.
It were harder in my day. We had to dig our way out.
See, now say, in pandemic, we had to, you know, yeah, we couldn't leave our houses.
We couldn't leave our houses. We had to dig our way out.
We had to stay in on MySpace and ICQ and Facebook and Bebo and Face Party and all those, yeah.
What was that sketch? Because I'd never seen that sketch, and basically me and my mum were sat outside.
Yeah, it's the four. It's a Monty Python. It's the four Yorkshiremen.
I'd never even heard of this sketch, and my dad put it on because me and mum were like, you know, well, I had this happen to me, blah blah blah. My mum was like, yes, but I had this happen to me, and it was much worse. And then I'd do it, and my dad would just like laughing his head off, and played me this four Yorkshiremen.
Can you top me up as well?
Four Yorkshiremen sketch. And I'd never even heard this thing before. And then Jamie, every time I say something and it sounds really Yorkshire, he starts out with this, oh, in my day we had to lick the road clean. And it just makes me laugh. But anyway, now I know what it means. I know where it's coming from. Right. Blah, 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 blah. Hi, Andrew Halliwell. Hope you're keeping well. Do you have a favourite prog band apart from Stephen Wilson? It needed that bit putting on the end, didn't it? Actually, I've been getting into... who's that guitarist, Jamie? Who's that guitarist from Bradford that I've been getting into?
Alan Holdsworth.
Alan Holdsworth. Been getting into loads of Alan Holdsworth at the moment. So, literally, while I sit there doing all my admin stuff, I just have Alan Holdsworth. It was like his first album or whatever. I just have that on constant. It's really good. Apart from Country, it's radio. Oh, Kevin Duff put, it's great to hear Chantel and Jamie play, but having a chat is good too. I think it's quite nice that people can kind of like have a bit of a laugh with us.
You can't really meet up with anyone. It's nice.
Yeah, I think that's the thing, because that's personally for me, that's one of the things that I really miss, is being able to see my family and my friends. And I guess it's the same for everybody. So I think it's kind of nice to do these little things where you just, you know, basically you sat in the living room with us having a beer, aren't you, essentially. And I think it's quite nice. Right. Paul Hawley, do you have a favourite gig that you've played? I reckon it's Bury St Edmunds. Either that or Ramblin' Man, because Ramblin' Man were really good, even though I'd not slept in 48 hours and flown back from Spain and straight back to Spain. But it was still good. Was that an audition for Hovis? Hey, maybe it should be. I did one this afternoon. There were an application for, it was an advert for some car thing. And it was basically, it said, you know, what was it? Like, warm, friendly accent, preferably northern. And I was like, Jamie, apply. So I applied immediately and sent my audition in. It would be nice to find out more about Jamie.
Well, ask me a question and I'll do my best to answer it.
I'd like to know more about you, Jamie. that's lovely. Kevin Deegan put, it's all helping us through and very much appreciate it. Thank you.
And UK were a great band. So UK, have you listened to UK before?
No.
So the first album, so this is Kev Wilkinson who's, but check out the albums by UK if you're interested in Alan Holdsworth. So the first album was basically, you had, it was a bit of a mishmash because you had Alan Holdsworth, who's a real, you know, fusion jazz.
Epic player.
You've got Bill Bruford, who's a jazzer. And then you had John Wetton. And Eddie Jobson,
right?
And it's good album actually. It's kind of a because you've got John Wetton and Eddie Jobson who are more, well, you wouldn't say pop, but the more on the kind of the maybe
and
on the proggy side.
What bands were they in, Jamie?
So John Wetton was in King Crimson, and he was in Asia, and he went solo as well.
Didn't Craig play for him for a bit as well? I have a feeling Craig played for him.
I don't know actually. Don't know. Bill Bruford obviously played with Yes and then with King Crimson as well, and then went on to form Earthworks, which is a jazz outfit. And then you had Eddie Jobson. I can't remember who Eddie Jobson played for, actually. He's played with a few prog bands on and off. But then the next album, Alan Holdsworth left, and so did Bill Bruford. And then the next one was a bit more less jazzy, and they had, who was it on drums? Terry Bozio, I think. Mm. Yeah.
Right. Yeah. You're like a font of knowledge, Jamie. Mm, yeah. Font of prog knowledge. Who invented the skip?
Who invented the skip? Who invented the skip? Just infected spinal column in a bap.
What
is that? Yeah. What is that from Spinal Tap or something?
No, no.
I tried to think.
Who is my favourite keys player ever?
Me.
I guess. I don't know. It's tricky because Franz Liszt, Serge Rachmaninoff from the early guys. From the jazz guys, I like Herbie Hancock and I like Bill Evans. Modern players, I like people like Kit Downs. Prog guys, of course, I used to love people like Keith Emerson, Patrick Mraz.
Stephen Wilson.
And people were Jem Godfrey and Frost. All the kind
Who's
of...
Who's your favourite country artist, Jamie?
I don't really know about the genre of... more of a hip-hop guy, really. No.
That's because you make me switch it off.
Hip-hop, yeah, hip-hop.
Do you do piano lessons? Starting out with keyboard, any tips?
I used to teach, actually, back in the day when I was a student. And I stopped teaching to concentrate a bit more on gigging. But I've started to teach a little bit now. Just starting out with keyboard, any tips? You don't always necessarily have to have piano lessons. You can check out stuff on YouTube. There's some really good online YouTube lessons. You don't always need to read music as well. Sometimes people find music actually... The whole idea of piano is some people think, oh, you need to be able to read music, and it helps for some things, but you don't always need to. Have a mess around, check out some YouTube lessons. Obviously, actual lessons help as well. The great thing I find about keyboard, if I get on a guitar, I literally hopeless because it hurts my fingers. Whereas on a piano, you can just, I don't know, you can kind of make a nice sound.
Oh, somebody asked any Carole King numbers. Maybe we should just play... that Natural Woman song for a minute.
Curved Air, that was right. Eddie Jobson was in Curved Air, that's right. I remember the remember the one.
Should we play that Natural Woman song?
Yeah. George Duke, also, I've got his album, was it Brazilian Love Affair? George Duke, epic keyboard player.
Sounds like something from Club Tropicana. Yeah, let's play that song and then we can... check any more questions. Katie put, what was the first song that drew you to country? Probably some Keith Urban stuff, actually, because he's just, like, incredible.
It is Carole King, isn't it? Natural Woman.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know when you have that blonde moment going, I don't have the lyrics, that's funny.
Just let me Google them. Because I need my glasses, it's far away.
Happy, I don't need to do more, 'cause you make
like, oh, there's no reverb.
Yeah, that was kind of a yoga moment of going, there's no reverb, quick. Where did we get to? Right. Ah, I would love to hear you do a version of Nick Drake's Northern Sky. It is a lovely song, is that, to be fair? I do love a bit of Nick Drake. Well, apparently it's the 50th anniversary of Tapestry.
What? Tapestry?
The Carole King album.
Oh, I didn't realise that was the name of the album. Yeah.
Yeah. Awesome. Well, I guess I don't know if everybody's kind of done. I don't know.
Quite enjoying this.
I'm quite enjoying it as well. It's really fun. There's still 104 people watching on Facebook and 37 on YouTube, yeah. One on Twitch and one on Periscope, apparently. Yeah. So I don't know.
I think we should.
I don't want to get down to like four people because that'd be a bit sad.
99, you know. Just, yeah.
Oh, it still says 104 on mine. I prefer it. It's more optimistic. Yeah, so if anybody's got any more questions, please do throw them over because if no more questions come in, then we'll stop and go make our pork and rice.
We'll climb back into the hole where we came from.
What, the kitchen? Yeah, we'll go make us pork and rice from Airy Bikers. And
Airy Bikers.
Airy Bikers. So, yeah.
Nobody's asking anything.
We usually find there's a bit of a gap and then there's an influx.
Yeah, it seems to be that way, actually. I don't know if it's just kind of the way that streaming works, where there's kind of like nobody puts anything and then it goes...
Kevin Duff says, do a chat show once a month or every 2 months. This has been great.
Yeah, definitely. That would be good fun. I think the thing is kind of like this question and answer thing. It's not something that we're going to do often ever.
It was purely a test, wasn't
it? Yeah,
it
was more of a test just to make sure that the equipment's all working for the live stream on Saturday at 5 o'clock UK time. But yeah, so... what am I doing? Right, do a chat show. Back in the early sessions, you did great for... Oh, New Day yesterday. Oh, it sounded awful, did that? It wasn't very good. Will there be more Shed Sessions t-shirts? Yes, there will. There will be some more Shed Sessions t-shirts with a maybe slightly different design for the album when it comes out. When did you last play with a proper band? That was in February last year. I think it was Howden, the last gig. Howden Shire Hall in February last year. Can't remember what playing with the drummer's like. It's going to be weird. Noisy.
Actually, the weirdest thing is my one gig that I did in August, after a gap of, you know, what was it, from March to August? What, 5 months? Mm. The weirdest thing I found was playing with the drummer. This drummer was actually a quiet drummer, but actually, because I hadn't played with the drummer for so long, the noise was... It kind of shocked me, actually, because obviously when you get... You play, you know, every couple of, you know... play a lot with bands, you get used to the kind of the noise, but then you forget the sound of live drums.
I guess that's going to be a really weird thing, because I mean Tom's quite a well he's not the loudest drummer I've ever played with, but he's quite a loud drummer, so yeah, that's going to be a bit of a shock. Oh, Stevie's just woke up and having a drink. Would you consider publishing a book of guitar tabs? No. It means transcribing everything. No.
Actually, I was considering transcribing your solo on Easy Slide.
You're quite
I wouldn't use guitar tab. I'll be using, you know, like...
piano tab.
Piano tab. Picture of which note to play. Notation.
Notation. Yeah, no. No, I have no intention of trying to transcribe what on earth I play half of the time, because I don't know most of the time. It's just what comes out. Most of it's improvised anyway. April's all improvised, so it's just kind of how I feel on that particular day and what I've been listening to. Where have we got to? Are you working on new material for a new studio album? Yes, I have been writing. Are you in any way surprised at how you're coping with lockdown, good and bad? That's an interesting question, actually. Not surprised, because I'd kind of... It's one of them things, innit? You've just kind of got to get on... try and be your best through it, I guess.
Yeah.
I'm missing my family a lot.
Missing seeing people and going out to the pub.
Yeah, missing friends, missing my family, missing my parents, that sort of thing. But I guess everybody is. Everyone's in the same boat. So you just kind of make, we're just making the best of it and just trying to be really productive and do the shed sessions to try and keep in contact with people, do a squidgillion Zoom quizzes and and stuff, which is lovely.
Also, if usually we'd be both on other sides of the world now doing gigs.
Normally we'd kind of, I'd be running around doing shows, you'd be running around doing shows, and we'd never see each other. So it's kind of bad but good in a way, if that makes sense. Have you been to the Beach Hut Caribbean in Heckman White recently? No, but I do love their jerk chicken and rice and peas. And I'm pretty sure I had Guinness Punch there last time as well, which was really nice. Is Jamie not a proper band? He does play a bit of drums on his keyboard sometimes. Sorry, I'm trying to read these at the same time as answering them and not doing very good. Has Jamie ever strapped on a guitar? Yes, he has. He's got a guitar in the other room.
Lots of times. Yeah, I got a guitar a few years ago and used it with my band that I played with quite a few times. And
you used it on Christmas Eve for the Christmas carols outside?
Yeah, because it's the only thing I needed outside. I needed something that was battery operated. And the guitar is still... I haven't actually dug it out for a while.
That's good fun, that. Yeah. Christmas Eve carols. And has Chantel ever played a double neck 12 string? No, I've played a 12 string, which I really liked, but I've never played a double neck. I think it'd be too heavy for me. It'd be a bit, it'd hurt my shoulders. Jazz Odyssey. Yeah, we've not done that for a bit. If I win the Euro Millions on Friday, I will sponsor a tour for you and all of your family of the US. Oh, bless you. They won't want you to come back home. I probably won't want to come back.
When did you last go to the USA?
I was 17 when I was. That's the only time.
That was
I'd
only
ever
a few
been.
Years ago then, wasn't it?
Oh yeah, like 2 years ago. I've only ever been once to LA. It was nice. I'd rather go to somewhere like Nashville or somewhere. I think LA was all right, but I'd rather go somewhere a bit more real. Mm. I want to go to Nashville because I like the telly program.
Yeah.
And I want to go and eat ribs and wings.
Yeah.
And biscuits.
Biscuits.
Yeah, they were like breakfast
like bourbons
things.
And custard creams. And
no, they were like these
rich tea.
They were like these breakfast things, like a bready dumpling type
digestives.
Thing. They were really nice. They were different. I've never had. I don't like it.
Garibaldi's.
I like Garibaldi's. I had clam chowder there as well that I quite liked. Do you still have the Ovation? Yes, I do, but I don't use it anymore. How did you come to a cover on Inconsolable? Yeah, that one was a really weird one. Basically, Livy, the producer of my albums, it was when we were doing Lose Control, and he was like, oh, maybe we should take the vibe for this we were just taking loads of influences from loads of stuff, and he put on Inconsolable, and I was like, oh my God, this song. And I got completely obsessed with it and just listened to it constantly on repeat. That was basically why. And then I was like, I want to sing this. I want to cover this. So ended up putting Inconsolable in with the band and just really enjoyed it. Alison Punchard's asking about the text, but I'm not sure what you mean, the text. Because I can't see it on the video because I'm seeing it in a weird program thing. So I don't really know. I don't know. People are still watching, but I guess we can't go on all night. Stevie's enjoying.
He's a racket, isn't he?
He's been a noisy monkey. So yes, if there's any more questions or if not, we'll wrap it up and go make our pork and rice and watch Silent Witness. It's always really awkward this bit because it's like, well, there's nobody questions, nobody's sending any questions, so it's like, what do I do?
I ask you a question? Yeah.
Actually, yeah, ask me some questions, Jamie, within reason.
What was your first single, your first CD single that you bought, or first album?
Can I have
album?
It was Michael Jackson's Bad, and I loved it, and I still love that album.
I love that album as well. That's
a good album. We'll have to put it on.
Yeah. I think. The first album I bought was in 1998, and it was the, even though I never watched, I didn't really watch South Park at the time, but I loved the song, it was the chef song from that.
So we don't need to go
so
into
so basically
that.
I bought the album, yeah, the chef that the
I think
South
mine
Park
was
album.
More credible, even though it wasn't very credible.
Yeah. And my first single was Canned Heat by Jamiroquai, which is an epic song.
Good hats.
Alison says on Facebook the words come up a slight delay and then a few odd words early. I think that's a Facebook issue rather than anything we can actually do.
Oh, is it like subtitles type thing, is it maybe?
I'm not sure.
It's nothing, I think it must be a Facebook thing because now we're not technically streaming directly to Facebook. We're streaming, oh, it's really complicated. Basically, we're streaming to inputting into a program called OBS, then sending that to a website that's the server that's firing it out to all the other places. So we're technically not going straight to Facebook anymore because it's going to this server, then going to Facebook, YouTube and everything else. So I don't know. Basically, I don't know.
Yes, like subtitle. Yeah, so basically on that's... Was that on Facebook? I thought it was a YouTube thing where the subtitles came up.
I don't know.
It'll be a setting in Facebook where you just have to turn your subtitles off. That's all that will be.
To be fair, Facebook probably does not have a clue. I've just realised why my guitar's really quiet when I was playing because it didn't plugged in properly.
Oh. Yeah.
That would be that then. I don't know. I have no idea. It's too technical. I've had enough of computers this week. Does Jamie do solos?
Solos in what sense? Solo? Don't know.
I've never. Yeah, you've had a solo once. I gave you a solo once.
Yeah, I'm not that bothered really. If I do solo, do solo. But yeah.
Yeah. Did you play Holland before? Yeah, I've played a few times in Holland. It's lovely. I love Holland. Really good. What's your favourite song that you've written? Probably Anaesthetise, just because I really like it. And it's deep. Leopard in Doncaster. We're going to be playing there again. I think it's... Oh, I've forgotten when. Anyway, it's on my website. He did. He fell over. I don't know what was wrong, but it was quite worrying. I was really worried about him. This man that fell over at the gig. A few people have fallen over at my gigs. I had a person who needed CPR at the 100 Club. He passed out. It was like the last song. He had a really bad heart thing. And he fell straight onto my pedal board and unplugged it. And I was like, why has it gone off on the encore? And then I was like, oh my God. Anyway, he needed the ambulance to come and do CPR. But he's okay, so that's good. And then another lady, she passed out at the Flower Pot in Derby. And then another lady passed out at the Clooney last time we played that as well.
And she's funny, I remember playing at the Diamond a year or so ago, or maybe a couple of years ago. And there was this woman, she must have been in her 90s. She was right at the front, really enjoying the music. And she had someone had given her one of those, you know, you get at weddings, those blow-up guitars. And she was there. And I thought, oh, wow, she's really rocking, that's great. And then the next minute I looked... It was hilarious. I thought they were trying to lift her to get her on stage, and I was just laughing away. I was going, they're trying to get her up. And then I realised that she actually collapsed. I had to do the thing where I was like, and then the really concerned face. And she was fine. She was absolutely fine. She's just, you know, she took it a bit
too much excitement.
Too much, you know.
Too much
you know,
fun.
Yeah.
Blimey. Have you heard the Maxi Priest Robin Trower collaboration? Yes, I have. I heard bits of it because I was on this Zoom thing that Livy invited me to that was like Maxi and Robin and loads of other people. And it sounds really cool. If you were a tree, what kind of tree would you be? I would be a weeping willow.
Monkey basil.
Aren't they bad luck?
Oh, are they?
I think they're bad luck.
Okay, maybe not.
Maybe to be fair, we've still got a Christmas tree up in the living room. So.
Yeah, yeah.
Long story in that we got this real Christmas tree and I was like, oh, next time I go see my parents, because they've got like a big garden thing, I'll go take the Christmas tree up and plant it so we don't have to buy another one next year. Anyway, obviously COVID, can't go up and see my parents, so the Christmas tree still sat in the living room. You keep saying about binning it, but I'm like, I'm not binning it, it's a living thing. So we're keeping the tree until I go up. Right. Would you like to make an acoustic blues album? I was doing an acoustic album of my originals before COVID, but obviously I can't go in the studio to do it anymore because that was in a different studio in Leeds. So I've got to wait, and I might just ask for tracks, to be fair, and finish it off here because it's never going to get finished if not at this rate. Mm. Anyway, I think we should wrap this up because I'm starving, quite frankly. Yep. So I just want to say thank you to everybody for tuning in. We really do appreciate it. I hope you've had a bit of a laugh for an hour and a bit. Blimey, it's 9 o'clock. Mm. It's an hour and a half. Yeah. Well, that went really quick. Yeah, I hope you've had a good time. And please tell your friends, tune in on Saturday. We'll be on at 5 o'clock UK time on my Facebook page, Twitch, Periscope and YouTube. Please share it, comment on it, put your little chat things.
You're getting down with the kids. We'll be on TikTok next. Snapchat, TikTok.
I keep thinking about getting on TikTok, but I don't know how to do it.
It's a bit rubbish.
I think
really.
I'm too old for TikTok.
I think you're actually too talented, actually. I think that most of the people on TikTok seem to be just not very talented or not very interesting.
I guess I've got to think, would Stephen Wilson go on TikTok? Actually, to be fair, probably. Mm. Maybe I should get on TikTok. Anyway, yeah, so thank you for tuning in and watching. I hope you've had a good hour and a half just listening to us ramble and answer some of your questions. And we'll be Saturday live streaming to all the platforms at 5 o'clock UK time. I'll be putting a post out on Saturday lunch afternoon-ish saying, have you got any requests, birthdays, anniversaries? So please drop me a line if you want any requests and stuff like that. And yeah, I guess that's it. Well, that worked. Woo! That was really good. I really enjoyed that. Right, thank you so much and have a lovely evening, and we shall see you on Saturday. And I need to move that so that I can get to the thing to stop the stream. Thanks for watching. Bye.